what I decided to do in my ultimate wisdom is, I know we lined it all and manked it all last night, but I've decided to run the surface grinder and just tidy up a bit. Thought it sounded like a good idea. Scribe this out, and the way we're going to do it is we need 124 thou off each side. Left my apron somewhere. We need 124 thou off either side to leave us 500 in the middle. Okay, so this is 124 thou. So we're going to set this roughly. And we're not going to set it pretty accurate, actually. To hopefully that. Bring down something quite close. I'm not a big fan of this one. It's not the best. Right, I'm fine adjust it so it just blocking the light in. Just so it's just so on the end. Okay, just to scribe it out to make sure we don't get lost. So we put a line across there. Like so. Turn it over and put a line across there. It's marking it better now it's been on the surface grinder because it wasn't too very good before. Right, that's give us two lines. So that there, from this part from here to here, will be the top of the T. So this bit and this bit is going to come out. So we're going to mark it down the sides here to how deep we want to take it out, and then we can follow our marking lines. So let's have a quick look and see what we need out of there. Right, we need about 200 thou. So that was 125. So we go back in our set. I'll just lift the camera up. We go back in the set and we need to find 200. I've got a couple missing. 0.050, 140 and 400. I don't know what I've done with them, I've lost them somewhere. But hey ho, I can always make some more. Oh, we've got 200 here, so we get 200. Bring you down a bit. And now we're going to mark either side. So do the same again. If I can lift this up enough. Yeah, I probably can. Okay, just so it that's on the point like that. Just make sure I've got the 200 one. It does say on them, but I don't think you'll be able to even contemplate seeing it. Well, you can take my word for it, it says 200 on it. Right, now we're just going to mark the sides. I think this is the best angle for you guys to see. That's that one. It's just on that rough line I ended up with that milling cutter. And that was just on the top of it. I was going to take them out on the surface grinder, those lines, but it would have made it plenty narrow enough as a T-slot. It's just a shame it ruined them, but anyway, never mind, we can see that. So see that one's on the top. So we're going to take out this piece, mainframe. We're going to take out this piece here. So there's not a lot to take out, the small milling cutter. We'll zap down that. Now holding this is going to be a bit of a problem because how we're going to put it in the vise, we're not going to have a great deal to nip on. It's going to be right down the bottom here. Not very much at all. And it's getting parallels thin enough to hold this because we don't want to catch the top of the vise. So what I might do, I might mark out the holes and then put a bigger piece of metal in the vise and just bolt this to it and then move around accordingly. I'll have a look, see how it fastens in the vise and see what it looks like. Okay, so that's what we're going to do. So we need to mark some holes in it. Right, I'm just going to divide it into four. So we can just put a four. And then we need to put mark out the centre of those in the holes. So it's 101 inch 233. So we need half of that. 0.6166. Like something like lovely. Mark it off with the calipers. One, two, three, right, that's got it all marked out. 1, 2, 3, 4, they're all marked out and laid out. So, tomorrow night, try and fix it in the mill somehow. Drill the holes. Tap them. And we'll just mill this side off. Yeah, it's about 455 deep. So we have to end up with 255 at the bottom, so we're milling off 200 thou, that is. Right, bedtime for me. Roll on tomorrow night. Right, we've got it in the vise, and there's not a lot of room. Holding room. Oh, sorry, give you a kick there. There's not a lot of holding room. I'll try and get you. We're in the middle of the frame. Camera's quite close to the mill, so it's all in my way. And I've just put it in, so let's just see how we're doing. That's a millimetre gauge, and it's tenth. I'm struggling to. The milling table's going away from me. I'm struggling to reach the lever. Right, okay, so. I'm happy with that, aren't you? Just tighten it a little bit. Oh, I flew off the end. Yep, that will do me. We'll just check it for... That's pretty good too. Be more sensible if I stood the other side of the mill, wouldn't it? A clever man would do that. There's Al watching us, look. Oh, there he is. He's always keeping an eye on me. Let's have a look. Yeah, I'm happy with that. Right, that'll do me. So, we need to grab a milling cutter and we're going to mill this bit off here. From there to there. I'll do the measurement, set the DRO to zero when we get the milling cutter in, and away we go. Right, okay, I've just touched off, as you can see here and here, and on the Z, we want 200, so that'll bring us 200 down to here. And on the Y, we want to be about 124 in. That's a 5mm cutter. I'll take a few small passes for a start and see how we get on. I don't want to break it, it's carbide, so let's see how we get on. So if we go in, say 50 thou, give that a go, and down. Z. Let's try another 50. That's 50 either way. Let's see how we get on. Down another 50. To 200. Yeah, looks about right. We'll go in on the Y. We're in 50. Let's go in a little bit slower. Let's go in 25. I bet if I went the right way, wouldn't I? 9-2 on about another 30 thou. Take it 10 at a time. That's the 30. Fair on now. It's 108. Mm. 122-ish. 124, so we're about there. One, two, six, that sounds better. 1-2, 1-2-5. 1-2-7. 1-2-7. We're not far out. Within a couple of thou. I'm happy with that. Right, I'll skate around the other side and I'll just do the other side off camera. You get the general idea. Right, all we've got to do now is drill these holes. We're going to do 8mm. I'll just set the mill up. We're going to do it on the SDM mode, so each one's marked. Then we drill them, and then we can go back in the same coordinates and tap them. And so we're going to do them 8mm. So it's that one, that one, that one, and that one. Then we can saw them off and try it. Just deburm a little bit, and we should be okay. Right, okay. We're just going to run an edge finder along and just measure the overall width. I've written down what we need. Apart, they are from here to the width of them, or length of them, I should say, is one, it's a full width, there's four times 1.233. So the 1.233 inches to there. From here to there is divide that by two, which gives you these four holes here. It'll mark out on the vise 0.617. So we'll touch off here and drive in 0.617. That'll put us bang on top of that hole there. And then we can come from this side and find out. Actually, we'll do this first. We'll do the width first, and then we'll do the length, okay? That's if I can work around the camera. If we get the right gear. I'll zero the DRO. We'll pull away and just see how far away we are. Point 0.8, not bad. We'll drive over the top. We'll just try again. Let's try again. 6909. We divide that by two. So we use the half unit on the DRO. We drive back to zero. I don't know why I set the mill off. Right, and that should be centre. And it looks pretty bob on to me. We'll just put the table locks on the Y, just to just to make sure. Right, let's put the table locks on there. And I tend to write on here at the table. Locks are on, okay? Because the last thing I want to do is damage my table. Right, we'll do it lengthways and then which is the x-axis. We're driving, touch off very gently, zero the X, we'll drive out again just to try it, make sure. Let's try it once more. I've de-birded, by the way, I just hit around with the file and I got the unfisted bird, didn't I? Yeah, I'm happy with that. Drive along it. Just try it again. It's not that critical. Right, we'll ask that and we go. Bob on. Right, we can work from the centre now if we want. Or we can work from one datum point. Either way, we can work from there and do two holes that way, back, two holes that way. And then we've always got a datum point to work from. So I think that's what we'll do. Right, I'll get a drill sorted out. And we'll go from there. Right, I just want you to see this. What a hole there, hole there, hole there, and a hole there. Now, my datum line is the centre of it, which is 1. So, in the SDM mode, that will be number 1. And from number 1, we'll drill number 2. And from number 2, we'll do number 3, 4 and 5. So if I press the SDM mode number 1, I'll bring the camera up and show you. And then I'll show you where this will end up. Okay, so we've got SDM, 1, enter. Now if we turn this back, 3.7232, that should put us in the centre of our work. Let's have a go. And as you can see, this is on the X. Obviously, you can see this is minus this way, and we're going plus. So put it on 0. Right, that's 0. So let's have a look, see if we're on the centre of our work. Right, as you can see, number 1, centre of the work. So what we're going to do is drill this one first, this one, that one, and that one. So I'm going to move it now across to SDM 2, which is number 2 here. And we should end up roughly there, and we're bang in the middle. Let's try it. Number 2, enter. We should be 0.617 from that line. Right, there we go. Let's drill. Okay, that's number 1. Right, let's go. That's number one hole on STM2. Right, let's go to three. That's STM3. We're going to go over to four. And then number five. I'll show you up on the egg on the monitor. Okay, you can see the SDM function here. SDM number five. I write it on the vise because if I don't, I forget. Number five. Enter. That's how far out we are. Let's plow on. There we go. Let's have a look, see if we're on the cross. As you can see, we're on the money. Right, I'll change it for a drill bit and we'll bore them out. We're going to bore them out to about... Good question. I've got a program on my iPhone, I'll show you it. Right, I've got this program on the iPhone, Drill Tap Tools. We go on here, we're going to do an M8, you can see that. Okay. Not better. We're doing an M8, which is down here. So you can pick what you like, M4, M8, 1.25, 76%, and it's a cut thread, not a form thread. That's a form thread, that's a cut thread. And up here it gives me chosen drill size, 6.80, 17.64 in fractions of an inch, okay, or US letter 8. It's quite good, isn't it? You see that? 6.8. So we're going to put a 6.8 through, then we're going to have a look for an 8mm tap and tap them out. And I'm going to go make a cup of tea.